Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello ladies and gentlemen, the honorable lecturer and all of my beloved friends. First of all, let us introduce our team. My name is Nina Parabita. Also, my friends are Siti Rahma, Bella Cahaya, Vindiani, and Alice Johan. Ladies and gentlemen, the presentation today is about death, dying, and children. Now, I will read one by one our agenda today that are the first session is opening, the second session is introduction, the third session is presentation time, the fourth session is closing. Well, ladies and gentlemen, let's open our meeting for the next agenda is presentation session. For the first turn will be given by the first presenter. Please welcome Alice Johan.
What are you doing?
Not bad, but actually I'm quite tired.
Really? You must try to keep your spirit up.
Yeah, anyway, do you know the Spanish girl who get the severe injuries in an accident?
Yes, does something get worse?
No, she's getting better. The problem is her family. You know, every day many of her family members come to this hospital. Yes, but they always ask to put some food in special location near to the patient bed. Even though I know it may be very important for them, it's not low. What did you do?
Yeah. I think the best approach to play the whole prick this for them in the slack. Plastic belts placing it exactly as the family specific and finding to then the principal them steam lengthening depending on the pension status and where code condition.
Did it work?
Yes, I did the accept it and it happy improvement to remember to ask the family what the when you to do with the it's when the time is over.
All right, I'll try to talk about it with them. Thanks for the change. You're really helpful.
Yuri, welcome.
Next.
What is death and dying? That is defendus. Number one, cessation of heart, lung foundation or of wall brain foundation or of her brain foundation. Two, adhere irreversible cessation of circulatory and respiratory foundation or irreversible cessation of all foundation of the entire brain, including the brain stem. The President Commission for the Study of Ethical Problems in Medical and Biomedical and Behavioral Research, U.S. 1983. Dying is defendus relating to or occurring at the time of that or dying. Example, promised to fulfill her dying wishes. Stages of dying. Number one, Daniel, anger, bargaining, depression, acceptance. Daniel, on being told that one is dying, there is an initial reaction of shock. The patient might appear dazed at first and might then refuse to believe the diagnosis or deny that anything is wrong. Number two, anger in English. There are some modal verbs. One of time is might. It can be translated into mungkin, for example, a patient become frustrated and angry that the are sick. A common response is we me. The mind become angry at good, their fight, a friend or family member. An anger might be displaced into the hospital staff or the doctor who are blamed for the illness. Number three, bargaining. The patient might attempt to negotiate with physicians, friend, or even good. Then type in return for a cure. The person will fulfill one or many promises, such as giving to charity or reform and earlier faith in good. Number four, depression. The patient show clinical signs of depression, withdrawal, psychomotor retardation, sleep disturbances, hopelessness, and possible suicidal intention. The depression might be a resistance to the effects to the illness on his or her life, or it may be in anticipation of the approaching death. Extenses. The patient realizes that death is inevitable and Asia accepts the universality of the experience. Under ideal circumstances, the patient is chorgages, then is able to talk about his or her death, as he or she faces the unknown. People with strong religions, beliefs, and thoughts who are convinced of a life after death that can find comfort in the belief Jesus done and down 1989.
There is a cycle sign of dying. This is a different experience for everyone involved. Here are some signs of dying which must be understood by every nurse. First, confusion about time, place, and identity of loved ones. Second, a decreased need for food and drink, as well as loss of appetite. The third is drowsiness, an increased need for sleep and unresponsiveness. Fourth, withdrawal and decreased socialization. The fifth, loss of bowel or bladder control caused by relaxing muscle in pelvic area. 6, skin become cool to the touch. 7, rattling or gurgling sounds while breathing or breathing that is irregular and swallow, decreased number of breath per minute, or breathing that sweetest between rapid and slow. And the last is involuntary movement, change in heart rate and loss of reflexes in the legs and arm also mean that the end of life is near. Next. There are change in body after death. First, rigor mortis. Within 4 hours after death as a result of decreased ATP production and keep muscle soft and supple. Second, rigor mortis. Temperature increases by a few degrees each hour. The skin loses its elasticity and will tear easily. And the last is livor mortis. The discoloration is a result of blooding pooling as the hemoglobin breaks down. Next. Palliative care. Palliative care is the active total care of the patient whose disease is not responsive to curative treatment. The relief of suffering is one of central goals of palliative care in terminal illness, control pain of other symptoms or of psychological, social, and spiritual problem is paramount. The goal of palliative care is the achievement of the best possible quality of life for patients and their families. Palliative care is a special care which affirm life and reject dying as a normal process, neither hastens nor postpones. It provides relief from pain and other distressing symptoms. Next. There are words connected with death and dying. The first I said in English, and the second I said in Indonesian. Acceptance, penerimaan, anger, kemarahan, autopsy or postmortem is autopsy, bereaving is penawaran, bereavement is kehilangan, body or corpse is jasad, burial is penguburan, cemetery is tempat pemakaman, coffin is peti mati, koma, dalam kondisi koma, cremation is kremasi, death is kematian, death certificate is surat kematian, denial is penolakan, depression is depresi, diagnose is mendiagnosis. Next.
Riding team, when a Muslim dies in hospital, the family might experience a great deal of existential anxiety if they feel that health care staff are unfamiliar with Muslim tradition. Christianly, it is seem ten of put on some glass so that you do not dog the body directly the face of the person who has this slope be tumred toward mesa strike then the arms and legs and close the mouth the mouth and ears after that the body is has had by family members of the some sect and is repeated in throat according the Islamic tradition a dead person's slope be buried as soon as possible prepare with dua empat horse a Muslim is all breed never comrade post mortem extinction are discredited uslek they are regulated by law. Next. Translate, ketika seseorang muslim meninggal di rumah sakit, keluarga mungkin mengalami banyak kecemasan jika mereka merasa bahwa petugas kesehatan tidak terbiasa dengan tradisi muslim. Pertama, penting untuk mengenakan sarung tangan agar Anda tidak menyentuh tubuh secara langsung. Wajah orang yang telah meninggal harus menghadap ke kiblat. Luruskan tangan dan kaki serta tutup mulut dan mata. Setelah kematian, jenazah dimandikan oleh anggota keluarga yang berjenis kelamin sama dan dibungkus dengan kain kafan putih. Menurut tradisi Islam, orang mati harus dikuburkan segera mungkin. Lebih baik dalam waktu 24 jam, seseorang muslim selalu dikuburkan, tidak pernah dikremasi. Dikremasi, pemeriksaan post mortem tidak dianjurkan kecuali diwajibkan oleh hukum. Next.
The gerund is a verb that acts like a noun in a sentence. The gerund is a verb that acts like a noun in a sentence. The subject in which the names are used in the sentence is used in the case of the object. The gerund is obtained by adding the ing take to a verb root. The gerund always has the same function as a noun, although it looks like a verb. Example, swimming in the ocean has been Sharon's passion since she was 5 years old. The ballerina took us dancing. Apologizing to me is not enough this time. She is afraid of flying. They are capable of doing hard work. Next. First, the gerund as the subject of the sentence. Example, eating people is wrong, hunting tigers is dangerous, flying makes me nervous, brushing your teeth is important, smoking causes lung cancer. Second, the gerund as the complement of the verb to be. Example, one of his duties is attending meetings. The hardest things about learning English is understanding the gerund. One of life's pleasure is having breakfast in bed. Next. Third, the gerund after prepositions. The gerund must be used when a verb comes after a preposition. This is also true of certain expressions ending in a preposition. For example, the expression in spite of and there's no point in example. By crying like a baby, you won't get anywhere in life. Exercise is futile without eating healthily. He wanted to learn more about riding a bike. Detective were relieved after finding the evidence. Fourth, the gerund after phrasal verb. The word to is a preposition and must be followed by a gerund. Example, I look forward to hearing from you soon. I'm used to waiting for buses. She didn't really take to studying English. When will you get around to moving the grass? Next.
Five, the gerund in components. In components using the gerund, it is clear that the meaning is that of a noun, not of a continuous verb. For example, with the word swimming pool, it is a pool for swimming in. It is not a pool that is swimming. Example, I am giving Sally a driving lesson. They have a swimming pool in their backyard. I bought some new running shoes. Point six, the gerund after some expression. The gerund is necessary after the expression can help, can stand, to be word, and it's no use. Example, she couldn't help falling in love with him. I can stand being stuck in traffic jams. It's no use trying to escape. It might be worth phoning the station to check the time of the time. Next, use of gerund. Use of gerund as the subject of a verb. Consider the following an example. Seeing is believing. Hunting tiger is not allowed in this country. And point two, a gerund is used as the object of the transitive verb, such as the following instance. Stop praying. I like reading prose. She contemplated marrying her cousin. Next. Point three. The gerund is used as the object of preposition, as shown in the following example below. One, I am tired of playing. Two, she is fond of swimming. Three, she was punished for telling a lie. Four, I have an aversion to skating. Five, we were prevented from saying the fashion. Point four, a gerund is also used as a complement to a verb to explain more about the verb. For instance, one, what I most detest is smoking. Point five, the gerund is used optionally as explained in the following. Example, when playing cards being her aversion, we did not play poker. Next. And rules of gerund. One, the noun of pronoun preceding gerund should always be in the positive case. For example, one, my teacher grew angry on my reading late in class. Two, he left for London without my knowing. And point two, there are some verbs which are directly followed by a gerund. These are avoid, escape, devour, detest, dislike, enjoy, finish, resist, mind, risk, reason, mind, practice, etc. And for example, one, I called Noel racist locally as he's easily acrobat. Two, we won't escape paying his income tax. And three, have you finished writing the books?